Shalom, shalom, family. Once again, you're now under the sounds of the voice of your brother, your aunt, Kahan Tazadaq. And as usual, the information I'm about to give you is not legal advice. It's not really legal anyways, but all of my videos, I may provide legal information, but not legal advice. And to all of the people that's actually showing a lot of love, sharing the videos, spreading this like insight and information, all praise is due to the Most High. And to all of the naysayers, all of the haters, like this guy Angel, that came to me for a wealth of knowledge, and then he got into his emotions and went into bitch mode and try and badmouth me. All of you out there like that, I just want to say fuck all of you all, and thank you for the hate. With that being said, and that out of the way, let's continue on. You know, this website, Deprogram Enlightener, or Creditors, Debtors, Contracts, and Commerce.org, or www.lordsheepofisrael.org, or the Undaunted National Channel, my videos, any documents, is a service made available by Creditors, Debtors, Contracts, and Commerce to Tazadaq Shah, and partners and affiliates and subsidiaries, which essentially are providers. You know, this website, these videos, documents provide general information only that may be related to law and lawyers, designed to help users and brothers and sisters to safely cope with their own legal needs. However, this website, any other websites that you may see Tazadaq Shah and family on, does not provide legal advice. Stop asking me for advice. I feel that you are actually trying to deceive me or play semantics with me. This website, my documents, my videos does not provide legal advice. It's not a law firm. We're not lawyers, nor do we have any desire whatsoever to be a lawyer or an attorney. None of our customer service representatives or lawyers or attorneys, nor do they ever intend to be. They do not provide legal advice. I do not provide legal advice. Although we go to great lengths to make sure our information is accurate and useful, we recommend that you consult a lawyer or an attorney if you want legal advice. Point blank, period. No attorney-client or confidential relationships exist or will be formed between you, Tazadaq Shah, and providers or any other representative. Now, with that being said and that out of the way, and this is applied to all of my videos henceforth and all of my videos in the past, with that out of the way, family, what I wanted to talk to you about is the movie Get Out. I want to show you the psychological profile of many Edomites regarding the movie and many things that our people or probably overlooking, but I'm going to give you some insight. Because not only do I have foresight, I have insight, not just the ability to look at things and discern what's going to happen, which is foresight. I have the ability granted to me by the Creator to be able to look into things and see what's happening and why they're happening. So while, you know, so-called white America, Edomites, are both, you know, and this is according with the information, understand this. This information that I'm about to put out, it may ruffle a few feathers, as many of my videos do. It is not my intent. My only intent is to tell the truth, and if you don't want to hear the truth, get off of the channel now, because I don't know anything more constructive than giving you right knowledge and truth. So if you want to play the race card and say, oh, Tazadaq is being racial, no, I'm not. Some of the information that I'm about to cite is from Cornell University. Other information is from your own geneticist and scientist. So what I'm doing is educating you. This is in no way racially biased. I am a dispatcher of information that's true. A right knowledge. With that being said, recent studies at Cornell University, according to them, white America are both genetically weaker. Not according to Tazadaq, Shah. And please, so-called white folks, don't be offended. Just hear it out. Because one of the problems that many people have is that if you've actually been programmed with so much bad information, when white information try to enter into your thought process, you reject that information or you screen that information with your bad information. And if the right knowledge, if the right information, if the factual information conflicts with the bad information that you've actually previously been programmed with, you reject right knowledge and therefore you remain programmed. However, it is my duty to deprogram and enlighten all so-called whites, so-called blacks, so-called Hispanics, all. So I just bring the truth and right knowledge. Once I've done that, then you're in the valley of decision to determine whether or not you're going to be deprogrammed and enlightened with right knowledge, or that you're going to remain a puppet having your strings pulled by the puppet masters. So according to some recent research, white Americans, according to Cornell University, are both genetically weaker and less diverse than their so-called black compatriots. Tazadaq, well, I mean, you're using words that we're not familiar with. Simply, a compatriot is just simply a fellow citizen or a fellow national of a country. And since I am a national and not a citizen of the corporate construct, then I choose to use the word fellow compatriot. Understand that. So, a Cornell University led study stated the fourth. Now, they said, analyzing the genetic makeup of 20 Americans of European ancestry, Edomites, and 15 of African American ancestry, Hebrews, Moors, what title you want to put on them, because again, when I use the word Moor, it's not from the same position that someone that's actually following the religion of Islam and put on the feds would actually use the word Moor. When I use the word Moor, it's just referring to us with the copper color skin, when the term was actually used loosely, just simply referring to a melanated man or woman. Understand that. So, according to Cornell University, when they was doing this study on 20 Edomites and 15 Hebrews, researchers found that the former, meaning the Edomites, the so-called whites, showed much less variation among the 10,000 tested genes than did the latter, the Hebrews, you so-called blacks, which was expected. Now, they also found that Europeans had many more possibly harmful mutations than did the Hebrew counterpart, or you could refer to them as NBCs, Negro, Black, and Colored, and whatever byword you refer to as X. I'm talking about the Hebrew brothers. And they was actually startled by this information. Now, why are you telling us this, Tazadaq? What's the basis of you referencing this information? Well, I'm telling you this information so you can get a clear understanding of the movie Get Out. because some of you may have actually watched the movie already, and some of you may have not. So when you watch it after watching this video, you'll have a clear understanding why, you know, they had a so-called white lady that was a hypnosis that was actually hypnotizing young, black, strong, athletic men that they felt was superior to white men who was actually genetically weaker. Why her and her husband, who was actually a doctor that specialized in lobotomies, who was essentially taking the brains from the so-called white people that was over and placing them into the young, black, strong body of a young black man. Now, if you pay strict attention to the movie, you will notice that the lingo and the pronunciations of the young black men that had these white brain matters and so on and so forth placed into their strong young black bodies, they begin to sound more Eurocentric. They begin to sound like a so-called white person, but they maintain the black body. Now, if you go back and you look at the movie Get Out, or if you haven't seen it before, they often put truths in movies. So if you was to actually reference this study conducted by Cornell University that blacks or Hebrews are genetically superior to whites, then you could understand why they will make a movie while they were actually taking the brains from a white person and placing them into a black, because they're saying that blacks are genetically and more athletically superior to whites. But they want you to think, well, that's just the movie. It's just the movie. It's not true. It's fictitious. See, that's what they want you to think. They will put the truth in the movie so you can say, well, it's just the movie. And then many of the people that like to play the race card, and this is not about racism, this is about the truth. And if you love the truth, you will welcome this information. People that like to play the race card, they will say, yeah, Tazadaq, but whites or has superior knowledge. That's only because you've actually prevented my people from getting the knowledge that we actually once educated you with for hundreds of years. You prevented us from being able to read, to being able to connect with our ancestors, from being able to connect with our cultures, and then you say that, well, we're mentally inferior, which is a lie. No, you're not presenting the facts. But I'm going to get to that. So they determined that, now let me go back to Cornell University, but while I'm referencing Cornell University's study and research, I want you to think about the movie Get Out, and you can see how Esau used his young white daughter as a sex object, really as a whore, for, you know, a more accurate choice of words, to actually go around and lure so-called black men into a sexual escapade to be able to manipulate them and make them weak and lustful for the white woman, which was actually considered to be the prize that the naive, ignorant, weak, punctified, sissy, so-called black man caters to. Now, if you notice throughout the movie, the black man, he felt that something was actually wrong from the beginning, from the inception of him meeting this white woman's family, but he ignored it, as many of you have a tendency to do. Do you follow me? So with that being said, now, Cornell University said people, you know, African, I don't like to use the word African, I use the word Hebrew, I use the term Moor, but then some are African, descent are the masters race from which all races derive from. Not my words, even though it's true. We've been stating it for years. We Israelites has actually been stating this for years. So have the Egyptologists and the Black Conscious Movement. So this is not nothing that those that is actually awakened do not know. But it's something that so-called white people refuse to admit. Not all, just the vast majority. So anyone who is not so-called black skin. Now we know we're not black. So we're going to use the term melanated. That does not have melanated skin with woolly hair is actually inferior for the lack of a better word. Not according to me, according to scientists and geneticists. Now, white skin, according to Cornell University and scientists and geneticists, and straight hair have actually no biological use or advantage. Not my words. This is not racism. Don't get angry with me. Get mad with the scientists and geneticists that has actually proved it. Hebrews, Moors, Africans can survive the element of Europe just as easily as white Europeans can. However, the reverse is not the case. Edomites, white, so-called white Europeans cannot survive certain regions of the world and would simply perish in the process of the sun. Now, the evolutionary biologists claim that white skin evolved due to climate. That is absurd. And this is what the brother that wrote From Babylon to Timbuktu put in his books. But that is not true. And I proved that in my DVDs about who's Esau and so on and so forth. I disproved that theory by way of scientific investigation and geneticists. That is just not true. And it is absurd. It is absurd. Now, Gold, this man Gold, found himself that 50,000 years is not enough time for any significant evolution to take place. Yet, he subscribes to these absurdities. So, you know, people that's going around like Amon Ra Squad and they believe in evolution, 50,000 years is not enough for evolution to take place. So stop the absurdities. So the gene involved in white skin has not always existed in the human gene pool, according to geneticists, according to scientists. And it has a very low probability of expression. In fact, it is a throwback gene that is actually not found in earlier hominins. But it is in fish. Isn't that ironic? It is not a mutation, but a defect in one of the genes involved in producing melanin. According to the Washington Post, scientists found a DNA change that accounts for white skin. Now, the Caucasians, meaning from the Caucasus Mountain, are a byproduct of inbreeding. The geographical isolations of Caucasian forced them to breed with their own family members. This is factual information. This is factual information. This is why Caucasians' gene pool is much smaller in comparison to the Hebrews, the Moors, the African gene pool. Incest gives rise to all kinds of genetic disorders found high frequencies and in high amount among Edomites, among Europeans, but almost non-existent in the Hebrew population and the African population. Understand that. This is not according to me. This is according to science. Why are you teaching us this, Tazadaq? Because it is necessary. Because it is time. Because I'm tired of the race card being planned. And I'm tired of every time a Hebrew speaks out, you trying to label him a racist. Well, I'm not a racist. I'm a realist. Let's deal some more with science. Inbreeding is also responsible for the Caucasian phenotype, which upon close examination is remarkably similar to other primates. What do you mean? What are the primates? It's not according to me. This is according to science. Chimpanzees and other low order primates resemble Caucasians in their hair texture, straight hair, narrow features like thin lips, large ears, hairy bodies. These are not characteristics of Hebrews, Africans, and Moors. Talk back to me, folks. And I dare any scientist to disprove this because science has already proved this. Perhaps the most notable similarities Caucasians or Edomites have with primates is their very large ridge or bra ridge. This is what was stated on Wikipedia. Now, Hebrews, Africans, Moors, however, have very little body hair. Dark skin, full lips, small close set outer ears, and woolly hair. Woolly hair is a recent adaptation and probably the first to disappear with inbreeding. One of the first things to go away with inbreeding. Understand that. This is why when you see a Hebrew, an original man, mate with an Edomite, like the woman that was in the movie Get Out, if they had made it, you would see some of the woolly hair becomes no longer 9 ether, but closer to 6 ether. And sometimes, not just curly, but almost straight. So it is probably a mutation to starve off the lice, a major carrier, as witnessed in the bubonic plague of Europe. Don't believe me? Go and check it out yourself. One of the things that is noted is that black people generally do not get hair lice. And many want to say, well, it's because your hair is very oily. All of this goes back to melanin, folks. Let's go back to the movie Get Out for a second. Now, in the movie, they are suggesting that blacks are superior. That they are superior. They are athletically superior. Now, when we look at scientific and geneticist analysis about dominant and recessive characteristics, this is what it has to say. Characteristics on the left side of what I'm about to read is considered to be dominant over the characteristics listed in the right column, which are recessive. Now, Dr. Leakey, who was a geneticist, by the way, one of your own so-called white geneticists, he said light eyes are recessive, dark eyes are dominant, light skin is recessive, dark skin is dominant. You could get the recessive from the dominant, but you can't get the dominant from the recessive. Now, in layman terms, what that means, simply put, is that you so-called whites come from black. Now, according to the dominant and recessive chart, they said brown eyes are dominant. Gray, green, hazel, and blue eyes, all the one that you so-called black women say are pretty eyes, are recessive. Farsighted vision is considered to be dominant. I'm farsighted. Normal vision, or nearsighted, is considered to be recessive. normal vision is considered to be dominant as opposed to nearsightedness. Normal vision is considered to be dominant as opposed to night blindness. Normal vision is considered to be dominant as opposed to color blindness. Now, you find these characteristics of color blindness, nearsightedness, far more amongst so-called whites than blacks. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. As far as hair is concerned, some of you make me sick to my stomach. You black women, you going around, you dyeing your hair, you're making it straight because you hate yourselves. I got to talk to you, sisters. I'm sorry. If this doesn't apply to you, then don't get upset. If it applies to you, go ahead and get angry. But that's emotional. You will get over to it. But you will take this vibration back to you. So, dark hair, not blind, is dominant. Blind hair, light hair, red hair are recessive. Or recessive. Curly hair is dominant as opposed to straight hair. Full head of hair is considered to be dominant as opposed to bald head. Widow's peak is considered to be dominant as opposed to a normal hairline. And it's not according to me. This is according to genetics and science. Dimples are considered to be dominant to no dimples. Unattached earlobes like mine is considered to be dominant as opposed to those that have their earlobes attached. Freckles are considered to be dominant to no freckles. Why? Because white people that have freckles, that means you had a little bit of melanin get in somewhere down the line, proving that your ancestors were indeed Hebrews or black men or African, whatever term you want to use. So, you know, I could go on now. Melanin, brothers, sisters, gives Hebrew people, so-called black people, African people, Moors, superior physical, mental, and spiritual ability. So, unlike, now, I'm going to show you where they put the lies in the movie Get Out. Watch this. They said that they wanted to take the white brain structure, and they did in the movie Get Out, and they put it in the black man because they was trying to suggest that the white man was intellectually superior, which is a lie, because of his lack of melanin. Because when you go and look at history, ancient Greek history is stolen Egyptian history. Everything goes back to the melanated people. We are the educators of the world. Excuse me for a second. The phone keep going. Give me a second here. So we educated your mothers and fathers. We are the educators. Give me a second. I'm not done with the movie Get Out. Okay, so getting back to this. So melanin actually gives we Hebrews, you Moors, you African people, superior physical and mental spiritual ability. Melanin refines the nervous system in such a way that actually massages your mental, should I say, if I want to be a little bit poetic. But messages, you know, this melanin refines the nervous system in such a way that messages from the brain reach other areas of the body most rapidly. So in Hebrews and Africans and Moors, the original people. Now, how many of you know, and white folks, don't get upset. Edomites, don't get upset. No, don't get upset. I'm not making mockery. I'm telling the truth. And I don't, again, if you love truth, you will hear me out. Now, Hebrew infants, Moor infants, Black infants, African infants, they sit, we stand, we crawl, and we walk sooner than Edomites, than so-called whites, and demonstrate more advanced cognitive skills than their white counterparts. Why? If you're more advanced white, why does this happen? Now, by the time that they've reached kindergarten, something happens. Why? What's going on? Well, studies indicate that approximately 75% of the people that's actually teaching our Black boys in kindergarten and grammar school are what? Are white women. That most have actually had no contact with a Black man whatsoever. Now, how can you properly teach someone that you have no experience and no contact with whatsoever, but you try to teach them? And if you don't love them, how can you properly teach someone that you don't love? Something that you Black women really need to think about, and you Black men. We need more Black men figures educating our boys on a young level. Such cases, you wouldn't have situations and scenarios like you have in the movie Get Out. You wouldn't have a lot of Black athletes running off and marrying white women. Because ultimately, and I'm speaking truth, it's usually what happened. She usually takes you through the same scenario as Get Out. This is the truth. And if this angers you, what do I care about angering you when I'm compelled to tell the truth or the Most High will kill me? So, again, we can see why in Get Out, they're suggesting that, hey, we want these Black bodies. Because science and genetics has actually proven that Black infants and toddlers actually sit, stand, crawl, walk sooner than their white counterparts. And they demonstrate more advanced cognitive skills than white counterparts because of the abundance of melanin. Carl Burns writes, and I quote, "Your mental process, meaning your brain power, are controlled by the same chemicals that give Black humans their superior physical, athletic, rhythmatic dancing abilities, and spirituality. This chemical is melanin." I'm going to quote him again. He said, "The abundance of melanin and the Black humans produce a superior organism physically, mentally, and spiritually. This is why all the founders of the world's great religions are melanated people. All of them. Melanin is the neurochemical basics for which is called soul." Remember how the Blacks say, "Yeah, that's soul, brother. What's going on? He got soul. Look how he moves. He got soul." This is what is found in melanated people. Now, in the same way, so-called Black people excel in athletics. The greatest boxers are what? Black. You know, they try and put someone up there like Rocky Marciano. Of course, you know, he beat Joe Louis. Joe Louis was an old man when Marciano beat him, when he was washed up. But look at your greatest boxers. When you go and look at the UFC right now, they don't want Michael Bisping to fight Yoel Romero or Jacare Sosa because he's going to lose the damn title. Yet, they will give GSP a shot, a man that hasn't been fighting for 3 years. He comes back and he get a title shot in a weight class that he doesn't even naturally fight in. Yet, Yoel is the number one contender. So, you know, we see that when the so-called Black man decides that he wants to do something, you know, athletic, he usually go in and he takes it over. And the only reason this has actually not transpired in education is because a lot of our history has actually been covered up. But whites will actually learn if they do some proper research and unlearn a lot of what they learn, that most of what they've learned is from our people. It's just the truth. And I'm not being racial. You can't withhold information from someone and then say, we're smarter than you, after you decide to let them get, public miseducation and books after they're totally worn out. It's not an equal contest. So we go back to the movie Get Out and we see that what I'm saying, there's a reason why a movie like that was made, because it is the truth, but they turn it into the movie because they don't want you to believe that this is actually true. Oh, well, it's just the movie. No, it's not just the movie. You better wake the hell up. You so-called blacks better wake the hell up or you're going to die in your ignorance. So, this melanin, getting back, again, everything that I'm saying, I want you to relate to the movie Get Out. So, melanin, these Hebrews, these Africans, these Moors, in the same way blacks excel in athletics, they can actually excel in other areas in daily life as well, like they did in the past. Once the roadblocks have actually been removed. So, the problem is, there's a lot of roadblocks in our way, and the media and many white racial groups paint us as ignorant and inferior when it's been proven genetically and scientifically that we're actually superior, not just in athletics, but in knowledge. But you've actually denied us that knowledge since slavery. And you say, oh, well, just forget about it. Well, I beg to differ. My question to you is the Most High black. The original man was a so-called black man. And if it says he was made in the image and likeness of God, doesn't just that biblical reference alone suggest that the Most High is black? Just something I want you to think about. Because if the Most High is his parent and he was actually made in the image and likeness of God, would not the creator be black? Now, most whites, most Edomites, have what is known, again, I'm quoting science and genetics. Now, while I'm quoting this, I want you to think about the movie Get Out, those of you that watched it. Those of you that haven't not watched the movie yet, I suggest that you go and watch it. But if you watch my video right here prior to going to watch that movie, you're going to have a much more clear understanding of what I'm talking about. Now, I saw this from the inception of the movie. My wife didn't see it. I was like, I believe that they're using that white woman right there to entrap black men, and they're experimenting on them. And I hit it. I was spot on. I hit it dead on. That's exactly what she was doing. Why? Because the Creator blessed me with the insight to be able to see into things, and foresight to be able to see things before they actually happen. Now, most Edomites, most so-called white people have calcified pineal glands, which thwart melatonin productions and thereby limiting their moral capacity. Some of you say, oh, why do you like white music? I mean, rock music. Rock music seems so satanic and so on and so forth. Why is so-called black people more inclined to believe in the Bible and God than they are whites? Well, this is the reason. Because they have a calcified pineal glands which thwart melatonin production. That limits their moral capacity. This is not according to me. This is according to science. Now, this is actually located in the brain. The tiny pineal glands that regulates the body's organs. So esoteric tradition regards the area of these pineal glands as the third eye. Sometimes you hear people talk about my third eye seat, which is actually the seat of the soul of the body. So why did Hebrews view, I got a question. Why did Hebrews and Africans and Moors view Europeans as children of Yahweh, but Europeans were viewed, but you know, Europeans viewed Africans as soulless savages? It goes back to this. It goes back to their inability to be morally right, for the most part. This is why there's books out like 100 Years of Lynching, where whites would just take blacks and have what is known as a picnic, where you would pick a nigga for lynching because you knew that he was genetically superior. So you would, and whites would come from miles and miles around by the trains and bus to see a black man lynch or a black woman lynch. And then you would actually keep his body parts. Not only would you lynch him, burn his body with fire, you would riddle it with bullets before it was burned with fires, and your children will watch you on. This is that moral decay that the scientists talk about. This is how you're able to see things that actually transpire in the movie Get Out. This is why you seem cold, soulless. Yet you put that type, you put that title on us. Because now you look at what's going in Chicago and you say, look at the savages. Well, who taught them to be that way? Who taught them to be that way? It's because of the melatonin described as a mentally and morally stimulating, humanizing hormone produced by the pineal gland. Scientific research reveals that most whites are unable to produce much melatonin because their pineal glands are off than calcified. The pineal glands are often calcified. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. In fact, don't believe anything I'm saying. If you want to play the damn race card, we're too bad. I'm telling you the truth. And if you doubt it, go and check it out for yourself. Scientific research has actually proven this. Scientific research reveals that most Edomites are unable to produce much melatonin because the pineal glands are often calcified and non-functioning. So, according to studies, I want you to go back to the movie Get Out, because even though they were trying to suggest that blacks were genetically and athletically superior in the movie, they took the white brains out of the older white woman and put it in a young black woman, and out of an older white man, put it in a young black man, trying to suggest subliminally that whites were actually genetically, not genetically, but intellectually superior, which is a lie. Which is a lie. Now watch this, watch this, watch this. According to science, according to research, pineal calcification rates within we Hebrews, we Moors, we Africans is 5 to 15%. And the so-called Asians, 15 to 25%. But in Edomites, in Europeans, 60 to 80%. This is the chemical basis for the cultural differences between Hebrews and whites, between Africans and whites, between Moors and whites, causing some black scholars to raise the question that Edomites or European approach, that of the logical erect rigid anti-filling poster reflects a left brain orientation and reflects that they lack the chemical key to melatonin to turn on their unconscious and therefore cannot get into their feelings. So this is how you was actually able to lynch, rape, maim black men, women, and children. And today, the children just say, just forget about it. Why can't we all just get along? See, that's to keep you docile as Negroes, docile, like the white female did in the movie Get Out. She kept that Negro docile. Oh, docile ass weak Negro in the movie. He saw the signs to get out. Negro, you see something's wrong, get the hell out. And I'm saying to you right now, get out of bed with your enemies. All of you that can actually hear me. This is not a game, family. So, again, brothers, sisters, this movie was not just a movie. This movie was based on some truth. So, it reflects left brain orientation and reflects that they actually lack the chemical key of melatonin to turn on their unconscious, their subconscious, and therefore cannot get into feelings and emotions. They don't care about killing you, man. Why do you think it's so easy for a white police officer to gun you down and feel nothing of it and then go home and have dinner? It's not racism, it's the truth. And the world needs to hear this. So if you try and flag this, shame on you. Because you don't want to hear the truth. Carl Barnes writes, melanin is actually responsible for the existence of civilization, philosophy, religion, truth, justice, and righteousness. Individuals, such as Edomites, containing low levels of melanin will behave in barbaric manners. End of quote. I didn't write that. Melanin give humans the ability to feel, to care, to have morals, because it is the absorber of all frequencies of energy. Dr. Francis Cross Welsing, writes, since melanin is a superior absorber of all energy, it is essential to establish this understanding of Yahweh, God, and all energy. The fact that the albinos, she often referred to them as albinos, and she's white. She's right. Lack melanin. It may also help to explain why, in the view of many non-white people, they, referring to Edomites, the whites, lack spirituality and the capacity to tune in to and thereby establish harmony and justice. End of quote. This is according to Dr. Francis Quest Welsing. Now, scientific evidence of melanin threatens the ideology of white supremacy. That's a fact. After considering melanin to be a waste product of the body metabolism, which serve as a non-useful function, Westerners, I'm referring to Edomites, I'm referring to white, science has now discovered that melanin is the chemical key to life and the brain itself. End of quote. All studies and facts about melanin, brothers and sisters, suggest that after 400 years of attempting to inferiorize the Hebrew nation, the African nation, the Moorish nation, Western science is facing the sobering reality that its own self defined standards that we so-called black people are probably superior in both intellectual and potential muscle coordination. And this is why you see what's going on in the movie Get Out. They know the truth, but they don't want you to know the truth. So they will put it into a movie and say, after all, it's just a movie. But you black people, you better get out. You black athletes, you better get out. I hope you're hearing what I'm saying, because many of you are still asleep. Now, I want you to take, for example, myself, Tazadaq Shah, a self-made man that studies the law. I don't give legal advice, but I study the law. Yet you have Edomites. You have, and I'm not talking about all Edomites, but you have some whites that come along and credit themselves for my accomplishments. Why can you not accept the fact that a Hebrew brother was self-taught? And you even got some of you complacent Negroes. I believe someone taught him. You fix your big thibble. Well, I think someone taught Tazadaq Shah. I didn't think that. You fix your big, thick lips to try and sound like a European. Man, you make me sick to my stomach. Well, getting back to the movie Get Out. Considering these facts, what were these facts that I mentioned? I'm going to bring this thing to a close, but I want you to share this video, like it, and then if you haven't watched the movie, go and watch the movie. I'm not trying to promote the movie, just trying to wake you up. And to those of you that watch the movie, you should now see it from a different perspective. But considering these facts, which science has actually proved, not just the words of Tazadaq, and genetics has actually proved, now, you should have the ability to see beyond the facade and the unseen reality behind the movie Get Out. And some of you naively suggest, again, it's just a movie. It's not just a movie, brother. It's not just a movie, sister. But considering the information that I presented to you thus far, now I want you to reflect on the movie. The film begins with, you know, this Edomite woman, the so-called white woman, traveling home for the weekend to meet her parents. And the so-called black man is to meet his girlfriend, Rosie's parents, who live on a set. It's pretty much was like a damn horror movie, if you ask me. But her parents lives way out in the suburbs, in a secluded, wooded area. Now, her father is a surgeon, and he played his part well. And her mom is a hypnotherapist. She hypnotizes the black man and many other black men, he found out as he got there. Now, the guy in the movie, Chris, excuse me, he was actually questioned and tried to establish about, you know, it was suggested that this mom could actually hypnotize him and, you know, help him to stop smoking, but he passed it off and say, no, I wasn't interested. And, you know, when he first gets there, the father and the mother trying to convince them how they were not racist by showing that, hey, if we could have actually voted for Obama a third time, we would have actually voted for him, and so on and so forth, making the guy feel uncomfortable, you know, trying to convince him how nine races they were, which usually have a tendency to make black people feel even more uncomfortable and convinced that you indeed are a racist, to those of you that don't understand that. Now, they, you know, learn that Chris actually was a smoker, and the woman wanted to hypnotize him. He said no. She eventually catches him coming back into the house from smoking and picks up a little, looks like a coffee cup and a teaspoon, and hypnotize him that way and make him sink down into a chair. She's sinking him, going into his mind. Now, he also realized that the maid, which was, you know, a moderate young black woman, and the groundkeeper, a moderate young or like maybe 30-some-year-old black men, had the grandparents' brain members taken out and put into this black woman and this black man, because they actually believed that blacks were actually superior. So they look black from the outside, but they pretty much thought like a so-called white person. And the same thing happened with this guy that had actually had traveled there from Brooklyn. You know, they took the brains of an older white man out and they put it into his young black body, and he started sounding like a European. You know, so Chris eventually started thinking, well, hey, something's wrong. I got to get out of here, which is actually the title of the movie. He realized that he actually had to get out. And for the most part, he was thinking that his girlfriend, the white woman that actually brought him there to visit her parents, was actually on his side. When it came to the part that it was actually almost time for him to get out, he told her, we got to leave. We need to leave tonight. He actually went into her closet. He discovered that there was many photos of her hugged up with other men, just like she was with him. Yet she had actually lied to him at the beginning of the movie, telling him that I've actually never dated another black man. I've never brought another black man to my parents' home. But he disregarded this. Even after he saw this, he tried and tell her, we got to get out of here now. And then so she eventually comes clean and say, well, you know, I can't give you the keys. And then her brother, who was actually also there, supposedly he studied jiu-jitsu. He was there to also to prevent Chris from getting out. So eventually they knocks him in the head. The white woman had actually lured him to a trap. They knocks him into her head, and they're about to perform a brain lobotomy on him. But prior to that, they actually have him watching this TV and, you know, explaining exactly what's going to happen to him. But ultimately, his friend that actually works for the TSA eventually ends up saving the man. But if you haven't watched the movie, go and watch the movie, and you'll see that there's a lot of subliminal suggestions in the movie. In the movie, they're suggesting that blacks are superior to whites. But as I had just actually brought out in this video, you will see that scientists and genetics are also saying that blacks are intellectually superior, spiritually superior to whites as well. These are not my sayings. The only thing I'm doing is bringing you right knowledge. Now, you could do with it what you so desire. You could take it or let it alone. But when you go and watch this movie, you keep these factors in mind. And to all of you that are involved in these interracial relationships, you may want to get out. Don't miss the hidden message. There's a lot of black men that's actually engaged in interracial relationships, and you end up very sorry later. So I'm saying to you, get out. I'm not being racial, but if you see something that you know is not wrong and you continuously ignore it, like this guy did in the movie, get out. Get out. I'm not talking to you that have not went into the interracial relationships, but those of you that's in them and you see something's wrong, get out. Get out. And with that, I'm going to bring this to an end. I trust that you've actually learned something from this. Share this video. Like this video. Don't feel as if I'm actually being discriminative or anything like that. I'm just telling you the truth, giving you right knowledge, and the truth might make you mad, but it will make you free. Tazadaq, Shah, son-in-law. Shalawam, Yasha Allah, Korm, Yasha Allah, Korm, Yasha Allah.